Think about this. You're in Asia, it's after midnight, and you think everyone's asleep. But for me, gallivanting late at night in Seoul, to basking in the after midnight decadence of Hong Kong and the blissful parties of Shanghai, I've begun to understand one thing. Asian cities never sleep past midnight. My name is Jamie Aditya, your jaded daytime tourist and after midnight traveler. Jakarta, capital of Indonesia. This is where it all started for me. My heart, my soul, my humble abode. So after indulging myself in the nocturnal adventures of other Asian cities, I felt the urge to shed some light on what I think is one of the greatest Asian cities to experience after midnight.
Yeah, we'll have some sheep balls, please.
Mama, sayang Bobby.
Oh man, Yossi, man, that girl, she was hot, the way she was moved.
I love you.
Let me guess, you want me to drink snake blood?
As the capital of Indonesia and the most populated city in Southeast Asia, with more than 23 million people living side by side, this vibrant multicultural city has always been a place of prime significance to me. This is where I grew up. Its music and people have shaped my life. And on my first after midnight adventure in my home country, I stopped by one of Jakarta's iconic restaurants in Fathahila Square, a historic area with buildings reflective of Indonesia's past life as a bustling Dutch colony. Aptly named after Jakarta's colonial legacy, Cafe Batavia is laden with memorabilia of yesteryear. Images of generals, movie stars, and long-forgotten royalty adorn the walls of this 19th century two-story building. In fact, the building is also the second oldest in this historic district. Speaking of which, this is also where I've arranged to meet Yossi, an old hand and longtime comrade, a jack of all trades whose life revolves around culture and the arts.
Hey, dude!
Yossi, apa kabar?
Kabar baik.
How are you? How's the wife and kid?
Good and expanding now. Expanding.
Yeah, so Yossi, man, 8 years. It's been 8 years.
8 years, Jim. That's a long time, man.
Last time I saw you, you were sitting in that chair, drinking a beer, and but the only thing different was your hair was black.
That's a long time ago, man. You know, this is our history, James. That's the reason why I invite you to come here.
I wish, you know, they did what they did with this building to the whole area, to all the buildings in the area. It's got so much, I don't know, it's national heritage, you know?
Oh, yeah, you're right, yes. But this is not the only place. There's many places out there, man.
Yeah, yeah.
We should go. Have a look tonight, what's happening.
Memories of his time with me floods back even after an 8-year hiatus, especially his laughter.
Okay, for our friendship, old times and new times. And gray hair.
This land of Indonesia has always been a multifaceted place with a strikingly rich history that goes back thousands of years to the time of ancient kingdoms. And along the famous historic district of Fathahila Square, I get a somewhat startling first-hand after-midnight experience of one of Indonesia's iconic traditions.
Oh, I told you, Yos, something's happening. Look, it's Kuda Lumping.
Yes, man. 8 years ago, you will never discover something like this in here.
Well, let's check it out.
Yeah, come on.
This is an after-midnight street performance Jakarta style, a heady mix of whips, fire-eating, and bravado sequenced with traditional music. Kuda Lumping is an East Javanese dance form that's popular in Indonesia, characterized by legless horse puppets straddled by performers who perform a trance-like dance routine to enthrall audiences. One of the few possible origins to this rhythmic trance dance is that it was performed by ancient warriors before going into battle. Glass eating has become quite a standard treat. How does he do it? No one really knows.
Call it what you like, but you know, it's just straight up magic. I mean, how else do you eat a light bulb like that? And you know, there was, I looked in his mouth, there were no cuts. And when I asked him, how do you eat that without not getting cut? And he said, well, when I'm eating it, it's not me. He said he was possessed by a spirit, and this, once it goes in his mouth, it's actually transported into like another being's belly or something. So that's what he was saying.
But one thing for certain is that nobody can dispute the bravado of this particular warrior. From fire-eating men and horses with ravenous appetites, Yossi takes me to another After Midnight cultural icon, albeit relatively safer.
Man, that was great. There's a kuda lumping. And now, you hear that?
Oh, dangdut.
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 Some dangdut. Hey. It doesn't get more Jakarta street than this.
You see, with Indonesia being made up of no less than 17,500 islands, each with its own unique traditional music and culture, if there is one thing that ties it all together, it would have to be the music of the people, dangdut. The word dangdut itself describes the driving tabla rhythm that is the core of the music. What began as a form of entertainment among working-class youths in the 70s has evolved into a popular contemporary music form, fusing reggae, Western rock, Indian and Middle Eastern music, and danced in a somewhat visually entertaining way, I must say. So for those tired of sweating for space in cramped nightclubs, these mobile dangdut musicians cruise around after midnight for you to shake your booty to.
Hey, come James, I saw you something.
Next up, I Live Dangerously, and get a bizarre taste of some Jakarta street food.
Ah, ini.
But it touched my mouth, and the taste is still there. It is not good.
On my second After Midnight foray in the fourth most populous country in the world, Yossi decides to jog my memory of Indonesian cuisine by sampling a few After Midnight delicacies. You see, with a history of civilization and trade that dates back 500,000 years, Indonesia has developed a plethora of cuisines from an explosive combination of cultures. Tonight, though, my good friend has gone for a somewhat raw and upfront approach.
So Yossi, we're in Mangga Besar. I mean, I come here all the time, you know. What do you want to show me, which I haven't already
seen? Man, I'm not going to show you anything, man, because you see everything. But what I would like to show you, the test, the feeling. That's the reason why I like to take you to have something to eat, man. Something that you never eat before.
Uh-oh, I don't like the sound of that. Here we go again.
Listen, man.
If I haven't eaten it, it's because I probably don't want to eat it.
If you don't test it, if you don't eat it, if you don't try it, how you could comment then?
Okay. Let's go
there. We could that way. Hey, come James. I show you something. Look, this is satay that I'm talking about. Make aphrodisiac.
Satay ayam.
Forget about that. Satay kambing. This is
pretty.
Okay, this is getting a little bit more funkier.
Yes.
We have here, I can see that's goat feet.
And this is, look at this. This is what, you know what this is? This is, you call it the goat ball.
Torpedo.
Have a look, have a look.
Ini torpedo ini namanya.
Ya, torpedo.
Dinaikkan, Pak, dinaikkan biar kelihatan.
Bijinya ya ini, Pak.
Biji, ya, yeah, biji. Yeah.
So this is the ball, man. A ball.
Buat tambah kuat. Yeah, bagi orang pria.
Aphrodisiac, man.
Ya. Yeah.
Oh.
Ya, yeah, ya. Yeah.
It's an aphrodisiac, ya? Yeah?
Yeah, that's it. What I'm talking about, you have to try.
So this is why you drag me all the way here to eat sheep's...
Man.
Sheep's balls?
You have to try before you know it, man.
Okay, okay. We'll have some sheep balls, please.
Okay, yeah, boleh.
Goat's organ soup has become quite the ubiquitous fare in Jakarta, where everything from the intestines to the liver and even the disconcerting sexual organ gets cooked in a steaming hot broth laden with pepper and spices. Now tell me, where else can you find dismembered goat soup after midnight?
Wow, kayak begini jadinya ya.
Silakan, Pak, dicoba, Pak.
So, this is it.
This is the food I'm talking about, man.
It looks much better now than it did up there.
Yeah.
But you know what? Oh, what's this?
This is a...
Jengkol?
Yeah, jengkol. Jengkol or what?
What is it? Oh, that's part of the...
Oh, that's a part of the nut, I think.
The theory is that the consumption of each organ of the goat supposedly helps the corresponding organ in your own body.
What's that, Yossi?
This is a...
The brain?
No, no. This is a statistical... this is a
what? Really?
Goat bowl. Let me eat it.
These are the goat's testicles.
Yes, that's.
So basically, what I'm about to eat is congealed
in this
sheep sperm.
Yeah. That's
okay.
We should try that. Okay.
Here we go. Delicious. That was really good. No matter how much I drink, I still have that taste, you know? He didn't see, but I didn't actually eat it. I spat it out. But it touched my mouth, and the taste is still there. And it's not good.
Very nice, Jim. Very nice.
I think I had enough, Yossi.
Okay, let's go to another place then. We have to try some other thing, okay?
Thank you so much for taking me here, Yossi.
Okay. Thank you.
It's not that I don't like goat's testicles. It's I like goat's ovaries better. Yeah. I mean, once you've tried goat's ovaries, you know, you'll never go back to goat's testicles. Yeah, the ovaries. That's where the money is, right there. Mmm. Can we get some of that?
I guess I just couldn't stand any more jarringly phallic reminders of Jakarta's cuisine. Now I thought that since he hadn't seen me for some time, Yossi was going to take me on a romp through the bars and clubs of the city's nightlife. Little did I know that Yossi had another delightful culinary surprise for me, this time something with a bit more bite to it.
Oh, Yossi, you're so predictable. Let me guess, you want me to drink snake blood?
Ah, you got it, you got it.
Wow. Well, you know, Yossi, I've had cobra blood before, yeah. And I swear it didn't do anything. I didn't feel anything.
Sure?
Yeah, but I have heard that the meat is very good, and I've never tried the meat.
Probably we should try the meat, man.
Huh? What do you think?
Yeah, I think so.
This highly venomous variety of snake is prized in the kitchens of certain Southeast Asian countries for its reputed medicinal and sexual health benefits. The blood is mixed with rice wine and drank, and the cut pieces of meat can be grilled to tender perfection on wooden skewers called satay. Now, where else can you find highly poisonous cobras cooked Asian style after midnight?
Thank you.
Oh, makasih.
Makasih ya.
Oh, jadi ini. This is the
meat,
snake meat.
Man.
Okay.
This is the meat.
Cobra meat.
Meat. Man. So this is it. We're going to eat it, man.
Not bad, eh?
Not bad.
Just like chicken.
But a bit tougher.
Yeah. It tastes like a rooster.
Yeah.
Like an old rooster.
It was pretty good. Okay. You know, it was very tough, but I think we're so used to eating farmed meat and it has a freshness to it.
The lifestyle, man.
I guess whatever doesn't kill you can make you stronger, sexually or otherwise. After the break, I pay good money for a traditional dance. And end my Indonesian After Midnight legacy on a romantic note.
I'm loving with all my heart.
Here after midnight in my hometown Jakarta, I fed sharp pieces of glass to a pseudo horseman, gorged on the dismembered remains of a goat.
It touched my mouth, and the taste is still there. And it's not good.
And swayed my booty to the swinging sensations of the city. You see, in Jakarta, it's the rhythm of the city that moves everybody. There's a beat, a vibe that permeates through the buildings, the streets, the people. And that was when I heard the sweet sounds of culture on my last after midnight foray in this city.
Ah, Yossi, I know where we are. We're in Jatinegara, man. You thought I didn't know this place?
Sure, you know. Now you know where we're going now.
I know where we're going. When I was a kid, I came here.
Well,
it's like memory lane.
That. True. You hear that, the sounds?
Yeah.
And the sounds of Jaipong call, yo,
I
pay
know,
to
the
dance.
Sound of Jaipong, I love it. Let's go check it out. Ayo.
This is West Javanese or Sundanese Jaipong. Traditionally clad ladies dancing sensually to the sounds of a Sundanese gamelan orchestra. It's a melting pot of styles, from village ritual music to traditional theater moves, all combined in a complex, dynamic, sensual display. You see, when former President Sukarno banned rock and roll and other Western forms of music in 1961, it opened a door for traditional village dances and music to make their way into Jakarta's mainstream culture. Ironically enough, Jaipong, like rock and roll, is deemed too risque by some of the more conservative of Jakarta society.
Oh man, Yossi, man, that girl, she was hot, the way she was moving, and man, I love Jaipong, man.
You love it, eh?
It's like, it hypnotizes you. I mean, I can imagine if you'd had a few beers, and you had a bit of money to spare, you just keep giving it, you know, just get hypnotized.
You should see the hips of that woman who had
the
white shirt.
Oh, I said hypnotized, not hips. But, you know, same thing really, isn't it? But, you know.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yes, the night is young.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I'm going to take you to this other place that I bet you've never been to.
Sure.
Yeah.
I love that.
Come on, let's go.
Darling.
After that somewhat vigorous exercise in tradition, I wanted to take my artist friend to an iconic musical venue and give him a special treat on my own terms. I figured it might be a splendid way to end the night.
Hey, Jamie.
Yes, Yossi.
Are we almost there?
Well, tell you the truth, Yossi, stop right here. We're here.
You're full of trick.
Okay, come on, Yas. Come on. I told you I'd show you a place which you've never been to before.
What it is? What it is,
this? This is BB's 12 Bar Blues.
My God.
Yeah, you can come and jam on stage. And so I thought, you know, we get you on stage and get you to come and sing a song.
Come on, Jim. Never look. I'm getting too old now, man. Come on,
Yas.
No.
Don't be shy.
Yes,
come on.
Come on.
If blues and rock and roll is your thing, then BB's is the definitive place to visit in Jakarta. Everyone congregates here to sit back and enjoy some of Jakarta's best local musicians as they jam the night away. For me, though, as a musician in my last After Midnight adventure with Yossi, I wanted to show him, as well as my home crowd, a part of my own soul.
Come on. Okay.
Do you dance when you're numb? Or leave after you come? Are you up when you stay? Lord, are you easily bored? Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you find you procrastinate when you're faced with disaster too late? Do you cut to the chase? Oh, at first a sight and a face, yeah. Are you inwardly twisted?
It has been quite a culturally surreal journey through my old hometown of Jakarta. This is a vibrantly rich city, one that's chock full of history, habits, and traditions. Some outlandishly fun and vibrant. Others surprisingly eccentric. I guess for me as a local, all I can say is, Jakarta, gue cinta sama lu.
Oh, I love you. With all